So today narration with interrogatives of WH kinds, right? Well, when we were doing the interrogative sentences, which started with a verb. For example, we did this kind yesterday. I said, did you enjoy there? Yes, Kritika, what's in your mind? You come here. Quiet. Unless and until somebody asks for explanation, don't speak. I am saying unless and until somebody asks, don't speak. Quiet. There are 80% of the times there are things which can be avoided by becoming quiet. After 5 minutes, the things will be normal. So what kind of sentences we were doing? Interrogatives with? Yes? With? If or? Interrogatives which start with a verb. So did you enjoy there? Do you enjoy there? Are you enjoying? Will you go there? So the sentences which start with any kind of verb. Okay, so there, what was the main thing to remember? In those kinds of sentences, instead of the inverted commas, we use if. The other rules remain same, tenses rules remain same. Okay, the rules regarding the pronouns remain same. But when it is interrogative, then we have to be very careful about the position of the subject and verb. In the interrogative, subject is after the verb. But when you will be making it indirect, then subject will come first, then verb will come. So for that, I told you a rule, like first you try to make the given sentence assertive. What's the assertive form of did you enjoy there? You enjoyed there. So what's the assertive form? You enjoyed there. So the indirect form will be I asked you. Okay, yesterday I told you with asked, we should put one object. So its object answer will be I asked you if you now we had given sentence you enjoyed is past form, simple past changes to past perfect. So you, if you had enjoyed there, full stop. Okay, tense rule is the same which I had already told you. The golden rule is applicable when we have reporting verb as past, right? Second thing, when it is interrogative, you just have to keep in mind that instead of the these inverted commas, we are to use the if or whether. And moreover, inside here, the position of the subject and verb will change. In the given, subject is later on and verb is first. So in order to tackle it without any mistake, the better way is that you first make it assertive. In the beginning, you will have to do like this, and eventually it will become your habit. When you people talk with yourself, then you people speak, you change the direct into indirect speech correctly. I wanted to know if you were present yesterday. Do you remember the rules then? When you ask your friend, when you're talking to your friend, when you are just simply asking your friend, like, were you absent yesterday? But your indirect form would be like, I just wanted to know if you were absent yesterday. That's it. Provided you talk in English. Okay, when you will be conversing in one particular language, in that language, you never have to learn the rules then. So those who are, very used to English, for them narration, they don't need to learn many rules. They, remember the rules by default. Okay. So as you can say, automatically the correct rules come up on their own. Right. So it's only with those people who speak most of the time their own vernacular languages, Hindi or Punjabi or Tamil or what. So eventually when they come to English, they'll have to learn the rules. The best way to master narration is speak English, always listen to English, read. Anyways, I asked you if you had enjoyed there. Okay, so today we'll be starting with the next kind of interrogative sentences, which start with the WH. So I said, so it doesn't look nice, but I said, why were you absent yesterday? So here we have got the question which starts with the WH kinds. It can be why, where, what, how, when. It can be anything starting with WH or how kinds. Okay, but the rule will be same, that when you now change the inverted commas, you will not use anything. Why won't we use any linker here? In the assertives you used that. In the interrogative of yes no kinds questions you used if. But for these interrogatives, I'm telling you, don't use anything. Why? Don't we need a linker? How can we connect two things together without a linker? What's the reason? Think, you will come to know the answer. Why don't we need a linker here? Who is behind charm? Himanshu, get to the side. Yeah, try to give the answer. If you know the question, I'll be very elated. What's the question I'm asking right now? Stand up. So forget your online classes when you're at home and you're sleeping and giving answer. So here you must stand up first. Yes. What's the question? What's the question? No, this was not my question. The question was, why don't we need a linker? Then I will be making it indirect. Then I will not use any linker here. I said, why, whatever. Then the other rules will be there as it is. What other rules I'm talking about? Nana? What other rules I'm talking about? Like they will remain same. Stand up. Habits are changed. Tense. Tense regarding the rule of tenses. That will remain same. Regarding the rules about pronouns, that will remain same. Regarding the position of verb with subject and verb, that will also be applicable. Only one rule is there that is different. That is, we don't use if or that or any other linker. The answer is, the reason is that we already have a linker here. This why will be used as a linker. Is that clear? We don't need anything else. It's already there. God gave you the, linker on its own. So you have been blessed. You don't have to search any other linker from here and there. Okay. So whenever WH words come, be relaxed. Because your one job God has done. What is the job done by God? You have been provided with a linker. You don't have to search for it. Okay. So is that easy for you or not now? Okay, sit down. So now the answer will be, I asked, same rule, I asked you. I asked you, now speaker, why, yes, why you, yeah. Var means that is past. Past will change into past perfect. And the past perfect form of var will be had. Why you had been, yes, absent the previous day, full stop. So had been. Var ke saath you will be using had plus third form been. Okay? Was or var changes to had been. Right? Okay, now write on next sentence, all of you. She said, where are you going? Where are you going, Aman? So she said, where are you going, Aman? Write down the answers. Done. Now I'll give the answer. You people tell whether that answer is correct or not. Okay? So answer is, she asked if there was Aman going. It is absolutely wrong. Right? The major reason for the wrong answer is that I am using linker also, if also, and where also. So you don't need to think about anything else. So you can first, you can like say like it is absolutely wrong. Okay, now second option, tell whether it is right or wrong. She asked Aman where you were going. Okay, that is also wrong. Okay, third option. Don't believe that my fourth option will be correct always. So she asked Aman where was he going. Now, be careful. She asked Aman, he was going where? Okay. Now, be careful. Okay, Aryansh, you tell, I don't know the answer. I've been giving so many options. Each time you say wrong, you tell what's the correct answer. Yes, speak up. She. Yes, she asked whom? She asked whom? Then right here, after asked there should be an object, Chand. After asked there should be an object. So she asked Aman, yeah, where will come as it is where, position of the subject and verb. Where was? Question mark. Shall I put a question mark here? Okay. Yes. When we change the direct into indirect speech, does the question remain as it is? The question becomes assertive. You don't know this. Whether there should be a full stop or question mark, that's why you are not making it correct. Is it okay? Was he? Yeah, he was. Where he was. So it should be where he was going. Okay? Sit down. Next sentence, write down. Aryansh said to the teacher, Aryansh said to the teacher, what are the rules of narration. What are the rules of narration? Aryansh said to the teacher, what are the rules of narration? So now let me ask somebody here online. So all of you keep your answers ready. The online students will be asked to turn on the videos and show me the notebooks. So those who agree with what I'm saying, raise hand. Online students. Those who agree with me, they raise hand. Okay, those who are listening to me, they raise hand. Okay, Arshin instantly hand raised. Very good. Tanushka, well done. Yes, Arshin, Tanushka, Prabhgun, Mishti, Ravneet. The rest of the children are waking up. Yeah, Gursevak. So Diksha, roll number 11, not giving response. Jayaditya, not. Japjot, sleeping. Ravneet, sleeping. Ruhani, what happened? Okay. Yes, Ravneet, the color of your hand is very dim. Make it a little brighter. Okay. So some children are sleeping. Note down their names. Diksha, roll number 11. Gursevak. No, his hand was up earlier. Jaya Aditya, Japjot, Ravneet. Diksha, 11 roll number. Jaya Aditya, Japjot, and even Ruhani. Write down the name of Ruhani also. Yes, that Diksha now. Give the answer. What were the rules of? Repeat. What were the rules? Okay. What were the rules? Okay. So the mistake which Aryansh committed here, you are also doing the same mistake. Remember that in the indirect form, first the subject, then verb will come. Aryansh asked the teacher, now repeat. Aryansh asked the teacher, are you Diksha? Okay, Harshdeep. Okay, first, second part is okay now, first part is wrong. Aryansh asked the teacher. If you will use two there, then you are making one more mistake. Aryansh asked the teacher, what the rules of narration were. Okay, what the rules of the narration were, full stop. It doesn't look very nice, but it is so. Okay, what the rules of the narration were. Okay, next sentence. The students said to the head boy, yes, what will they ask? Come on. The students said to the head boy, yes, what will they ask? When are you? So the students said to the head boy, what are the duties of office bearers? What are the duties of the office bearers? What are the duties of the office bearers? Okay, Prabhu, give answer.
Ma'am, could you please repeat?
Students said to the head boy, what are the duties of all office bearers?
The students asked the head boy, what were the duties of the office bearers?
Repeat and take care of the mistake. The mistake which Aryansh committed, then Diksha committed, you don't commit.
Students ask the head boy, what duties what duties were of the office bearers?
Yes, that is okay. So that is okay, Prabhun. Mute yourself. So the students asked the head boy, what duties were of the office bearers? What duties were of the office bearers? Or you can also say, what duties the office bearers were having? Then you'll have to add one more word from your side. What duties the office bearers were having? Or one more thing, what duties the office bearers had? Okay, if you want to use the verb after the office bearers, then it can be had. What duties the office bearers had? Okay, or it could be, what duties were of the office bearers? Because what duties, that is subject. No, what duties were of the office bearers? Never mind. But with what the duties, you won't say. Okay, next sentence now. I said to my friend, how can you be so careless with your work? I said to my friend, how can you be so careless with your work? How can you be so careless with your work? Yes. From here, Ruhani, now give the answer. Ruhani, okay, Simarleen, okay, yes, Veta, you give the answer. What's your name? Garima. I asked my friend, Simarleen, don't commit the mistakes. Repeat. Think and speak. You have to take care of which things? Number one, when you remove the inverted commas, if you are using the same linker, when or where, whatever that you are doing, then you have to take care of the position of the subject and verb. Then you have to take care of the tense. Okay, who is I said to my friend? My friend means he or she, right? So I said to my friend, how can you? Who is you? Huh?
She.
Yes, she. So I asked my friend how she. Yes, very good. Very good. So I asked my friend how she could be so careless with her work. But do you think it's a question you are asking from your friend? Do you ask your friend like this? How can you be so careless? Is it my question? What is it? When your mother asks you like this, how can you be so careless, beta? how can you be so whatever? How can you be so careless? It's a question. Then what's it? Very nice. Is it, are you asking? How can you be so careless? Is it asking? Telling? Yes, it is only the way to exaggerate. It's only the way to say that you are very careless. Got it? I asked my friend. Grammatically, no one will say it's wrong if you say the same thing. I asked my friend how she could be so careless with her work. Grammatically, no one will say it is wrong. But yes, if you talk about expression wise, then its answer would be, I told my friend that she was terribly careless. Got it? I told my friend that she was terribly careless. That's it. Okay? Now, next sentence. The teacher said to the students, your exams will start next month. Your exams will start next month. Do you have any doubts? Do you have any doubts? In any subject? Do you have any doubts in any subject? Now this boy, Aditya Sharma, give the answer. Aditya Sharma is not there in the class. Okay, Janvi. Janvi is also not there. Okay, Mishti, give the answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, give the answer.
The teacher asked the students, ma'am, actually I have not completed the sentence yet.
Okay, Arshin, you speak.
Yes, ma'am.
Give the answer.
Teacher told the students that their exams would start next month. She further asked that she further asked if they had any doubts in any subject.
Otherwise, everything is okay. One very, very minor mistake. What's that minor mistake? Huh? What's that minor mistake? You are Divita. There is also one Divita. So let's talk to this roll number 13. Devita. Yes, Devita here, roll number 13. Unmute yourself. Yeah, left now. So let me read out the names up here. Arshin, Gursevak, Jayaditya, Japjot, Mishti, Prakun, Prabhu, Ruhani, Simarveen, Tanushka, Aditya, and Janvi. Anyone else? All here? Right? Okay, so what I was talking about, Khushi, give the answer. Yes, very good. Silent clap for Khushi. For adding the expression informed. Okay, it's not that always we ask or say something. Be informed. The teacher informed the students that their exams would start the next month. Any problem here? That their exams, what are spelling of their? T-H-E-I-R. So that their exams would start the next month. Okay, the following month. She further asked them. So asked them, add one object after asked. Okay, Arshin, you were not adding one object after asked. So she further asked them if they had any doubt in any of the subjects. Full stop. If they had. Right? Chand, when we study, we don't talk. But when we talk, we don't study. Right? The bell will go at its own time. Okay? When the bell will go, it will go. Why to bother for the bell? Bother for this? It will not come here on its own. Bell will come. Okay? So, okay, next sentence, last one. The students said to the teacher, what will be the weightage of these exams? What will be the weightage of these exams, ma'am? What will be the weightage of these exams, ma'am? Okay, all of you write the answers. What will be the weightage of these exams? Yes, Chayank, what's the answer? Same mistake what Aryansh committed. Never mind. Think once more. Yes. Yes, that is okay. So the students asked the teacher. Yeah, respectfully. Silent clap for Rahul. The students asked the teacher respectfully what weightage of exams would be. What weightage would be of the exams, or what weightage of the exams would be there. Okay, so add final complimentary word. What weightage would be there of the exams? Those exams, yes. Then those exams. Yes, children, revise all these rules. Okay.